Welcome to a new tutorial. In this video, I will show you how to make this baby hat. It's a model of a newsboy cap. And it's stretchy because I used a special stitch on this side. If you like my videos, please push the thumbs up so I can make more content for you. I've made a leather tag and I'm going to sew it on this side. Oh, I think it's perfect. And now about the measurements, because it's stretchy. It's 20 centimeter or 8 inch. So I think it's suitable for a baby from 6 months to 12 months old. I will be using one skein of this medium weight yarn, which is 100 gram, and it's suitable for crochet hook 5 to 6 millimeter. And one scissor, a needle, and a crochet hook 4.5 by Clover. I will start by making a magic circle. And now I will chain two. One and two. In this ring I will make 11 double crochet. I will yarn over, insert, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. So continue this in this circle. Yarn over, insert in the ring, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. So now I've made 11 double crochet. I will pull the strand to tighten the ring and I will make a slip stitch into the first stitch. So this is the first stitch. I will insert, yarn over, pull through and pull through the loop. And now I will chain two. One and two. And I will make two double crochet in each stitch. So this is the first stitch. One. And I make another one in the same stitch. And now in the second stitch also two double crochet. And repeat this on each stitch. I'm at the end of the second row. I've made 22 double crochet plus this chain two of the beginning, and on the first slip stitch of the previous row I will make another double crochet. So I've made a total of 23 double crochet plus this chain two, and now I will make a slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will start with row 3. I will chain 2, 1 and 2. And now in the first stitch I will make 1 double crochet. And in the second stitch I will make 2 double crochet. So 1 and 2. And I will repeat this all the way around. So in the first stitch, 1 double crochet. And in the second stitch, 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. I'm now at the end of row 3. I've made a total of 34 double crochet plus this chain 2 of the beginning, and now on top of the slip stitch of the previous row I will make 1 more double crochet, and I will close the row with the slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will start with row 4. I will chain 2 and I will make in the first 2 stitches 1 double crochet. So 1, and in the second stitch 1 double crochet, and in the third stitch I will make 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. So repeat this in the fourth row. 1 double crochet, 1 double crochet, and 2 double crochet. I'm at the end of row 4. I've made 46 double crochet stitches plus this chain 2 of the beginning, and I will make 1 more double crochet into the slip stitch of the previous row. So plus this chain 2, I've made a total of 48 stitches. And I will make 1 slip stitch to close the row. And I will continue with row 5. Again, I will chain 2. And now I will make 3 double crochet in each stitch. 1, 1, in the second stitch, 1, and in the third stitch, 1, and in the fifth stitch, no, in the fourth stitch, I will make 2 double crochet. So 1 and 2. And repeat this in row 5. And you can also always check where you put the 2 double crochet. It's in the second stitch of the previous 2 double crochet. I'm now at the end of the 5th row. Into the last stitch in the slip stitch I will make 1 more double crochet. So I'll have a total of 56 stitches, and I will close the row with a slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will start with row 6. Again, I will chain 2, 1 and 2. In the first 4 stitches I will make 1 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And in the 5th stitch I will make 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. So continue this in row 6. I'm at the end of the 6th row. I will make one more double crochet until the last stitch on top of the slip stitch, and I will make one slip stitch into the beginning. And now I will start with row 8. I will chain 2. I will make one double crochet into the first 5 stitches. So I've made 5 double crochet, and now in the 6th stitch I will make 2 double crochet. 1 and 2. And repeat this in this row. So now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is the 7th row. I'm at the end of row 7. And I will make one more double crochet into the slip stitch of the beginning. And now I will chain 1 into the first stitch. And now I will start with row 8. I will chain 2, 1 and 2. I will make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 double crochet. And in the 7th stitch, I will make 2 double crochet. I'm now at the end of row 8. In the last stitch, in the slip stitch, I will make 1 more double crochet. And I will make a slip stitch into the first stitch. If you want to know how many of these double crochets you have to make in each round, you have to increase them by 12. You have to multiply them by 12. So in row 1, 12, in row 2, 24, 36, and so on. And now I will start with row 9. I will chain 2. And now in each stitch I will make 1 double crochet. So I do not increase or decrease in this row. Just 1 double crochet on each stitch. I'm now at the end of row 9. And now I will make a slip stitch into the first stitch. And I start with row 10. In row 10, I will start decreasing. Therefore, I will first make a chain of 2. And now, I will make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 double crochet. And the 7th and 8th stitch, I will crochet together. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And now I will make 2 stitches together. Therefore, I will yarn over, insert in the first stitch, pull up the yarn, and insert in the second stitch, yarn over, and pull up the yarn. I have 4 loops on my hook. I will yarn over and pull through the 4 loops. And continue this in this row. So, make 6 double crochet and then 2 together. I'm now at the end of row 10. Last 2 stitches I will also will make 2 together. And I will make a slip stitch into the first stitch. And now I will start with row 11. I will chain 2, 1 and 2, and now I will make 5 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4 en 5. En next 2 stitches, I will also make 2 together. So insert in the first stitch and in the second stitch, yarn over and pull through the 4 loops. So continue in row 11. I have finished row 11. So this is how my work looks like. And now I will start with row 12. In row 12, I will also start with a decrease. I will chain 2. And now I will make 4 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 3 and 4, and the 5th and the 6th stitch I will double crochet together. Just in the previous row, insert in the first stitch and in the second stitch, pull up the yarn, yarn over and pull through the loops. Continue this in row 12. I'm at the end of row 12 and I will close the row with a slip stitch into the first stitch, chain 2, and in row 13 I will make 3 double crochet and make 2 stitches together. I have finished row 13 and now I will start with row 14. I will chain 2. And I will make 1 double crochet front post and 1 double crochet back post. Therefore, I will yarn over, insert in front of the work, yarn through, yarn over and pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. And I will make 1 double crochet back post. Yarn over, insert behind my work, pull up the yarn, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. Continue this stitch in this row, make 1 double crochet front post and 1 double crochet back post. This is the big stitch which I've made the increase, but I will make 1 stitch on top of it. I have finished row 14. And now I will start with row 15. In row 15, I will repeat row 14. I will chain 2 and make 1 double crochet front post and 1 double crochet back post. So you put it on top of the stitch of the previous row. So on the double crochet front post and 1 on the double crochet back post. I have finished row 15. And now I will fasten off. So I will cut the yarn So the measurements are on the inside 9 centimeter or 3.5 inch, and the outside is 9 inch or 23 centimeter. And now I'm going to work on the brim. I will make the brim on the front part. This is the back part. And now I will put some stitch markers where on to see how big I want to make the brim. Therefore, I will fold the hat together. And I put a stitch marker on this side. And one on this side. And I will use a smaller hook. This is size of 4 millimeter, also by Clover, which are my favorite crochet hooks. And I will insert in this part, in the stitch where I put the stitch marker, I will yarn over, pull through, yarn over the 2 strands and pull through and chain 1. And now I will make a double crochet front post on each stitch. So yarn over, insert in the first stitch, pull through the yarn, yarn over and pull through 2, yarn over and pull through 2. So on the next stitch, and I will go all the way until the next stitch marker. I arrived at the next stitch marker and I will remove it to make the stitch. On this stitch, also make 1 double crochet front post. And now I will turn my work and start with the second row of the brim. Therefore, I will chain 2, 1 and 2. And now on the first 2 stitches of the previous row, I will make a double crochet back post together. Therefore, I will insert behind the stitch of the previous row, behind the 2 stitches, pull the yarn, yarn over and pull through 2. And pull through 2. So I've made 2 stitches together to decrease. And now on the next stitches, I will make 1 double crochet back post on each stitch. So insert in the back of the stitch and I will repeat this until I have 2 stitches left. I'm at the end of the second row and I have 2 stitches left, and I will make those 2 together. So also do double crochet back post like this. And now I will turn my work, start with the third row. I will chain 2, 1 and 2, and on this row I will make a double crochet front post. The first 2 stitches I will make together, so Insert in front of the two stitches, yarn over and pull through, and make a double crochet. And now on each stitch, I will make one double crochet front post. So insert in front of each stitch until I have two stitches left on this part. And now I will start with row 3. I will chain 2. I will chain 2, 1 and 2. And on this row I will make a double crochet front post on each stitch. 1 So continue making this on each stitch. So you can see I have added 3 rows to make this brim. I will add 2 more, but if you like you can keep it this way. I will add 2 more rows, and in the row 4 I will make a double crochet back post, and in row 5 I will make a double crochet front post.